It is my pleasure tonight to introduce our main speaker, and I think this is my first opportunity of getting to introduce my new boss, so I'm excited about that. But the State of the Arts Address is traditionally at the center of the Governor's Awards in the Arts, and it is a true pleasure and an honor to have Governor Kristi Noem with us tonight to give her first State of the Arts Address. We know through her work with the South Dakota Legislature that Governor Noem understands the significant impact that the arts have on our state's tourism economy. As our state's representative in the U.S. Congress, Governor Noem proved her commitment to arts education by continuing the Congressional Art Competition for South Dakota students and in working to pass bipartisan education policy which positioned the arts as essential to a well-rounded education. While in D.C., Governor Noem also supported maintaining funding for the National Endowment for the Arts and National Endowment for the Humanities, and she joined the Congressional Arts Caucus. Before she even took the oath of office, Governor Noem reappointed me to lead the Department of Tourism at the state level to continue our work positioning the arts as an essential component of cultural tourism. Governor Noem, I am happy to report, has hit the ground running with arts initiatives and policy in South Dakota. During her first month in office, she has already appointed the newest advisor to the South Dakota Arts Council, Keith Braveheart. And just last week, she met with the Arts Council staff to discuss the Veterans Arts and Health Initiative at the state's Veterans Home in Hot Springs, as well as the State Art for State Office Buildings program and the South Dakota Artists Laureate program. We are very, very excited to get to work with Governor Noem, and it is indeed my pleasure to introduce her tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Governor Kristi Noem.
Well, good evening. It is wonderful to see all of you. I appreciate your focus on the arts, your investment in our state, and it just means the world to me. Now, information I probably should have shared earlier was I'm a trumpet player. So I totally could have been over there just, you know, hurting your ears all evening because I wasn't a great trumpet player. So, you know, this is an intimidating room because there are so many gifts and talents in this room. And I'm not an artist. I'm not a good dancer, I'm not a good singer, so every workshop that you have, sign me up. I will be there and would love to be the recipient of all of your creative juices and investment into not only me, but to our state and to our youth. And just thank you. Thank you for sharing your gifts with the people of South Dakota and with the world, because it's just outstanding that we have the culture and the rich heritage that we have here in South Dakota. Now, starting from my early days in the South Dakota Legislature and continuing throughout my service in Congress, I worked with many of you to emphasize the importance of your work in our state. Throughout the years, we've discussed policy matters as diverse as education, business taxes, public health, and cultural preservation. I've been pleased to find such a strong connection between the goals of our statewide arts organizations and my goals as governor. You set a strong example for South Dakotans. You operate on modest financial resources, you have small staffs, and you have as little red tape as possible. You work in partnership with constituents and are a model for efficient and highly accountable service to your communities. You're pillars in your communities, providing cultural, educational, economic, civic, and public health benefits. Despite the successes that arts brings into our hometowns, I know that there are a lot of myths out there regarding public funding for the arts. And so I'd like to talk about some of those myths here tonight. Myth number one that people tend to believe is that government support for the arts primarily benefits the urban elite. And this, in fact, is not true. In fact, I would even argue that the arts are most important for people who aren't the urban elite. In 2014, I led the House in passing a bill that gave kids in foster care the opportunity to participate in extracurricular activities like jazz band, or the dance team, or the school play. Foster kids are often some of the most vulnerable ones in our society, and participation in the arts may give them an escape, a chance to find a passion, to experience a sense of pride and accomplishment. This wouldn't be possible without the work that each of you do. Arts projects often are the most impactful in our smaller communities. In April of last year, the town of Frederick held a folk fest to honor the Swedish and the Finnish heritage of that area. This was only possible because of the sponsorship of the South Dakota and Aberdeen Arts Councils. During that week-long event, a group called Cardament, I think I said that right, but they taught folks about their cultural background. I heard that they even got some high school students to sing along, which is quite an accomplishment. These kinds of arts events create connectedness in communities. They make sure that our hometowns are places where people want to be, where our kids want to stay, and where businesses will want to bring their employees. Now, myth number two is that individual grants keep artists afloat. Well, most grant funds going to artists are for the specific purpose of hiring the artist to teach, to perform, or create artwork for a specific project. Artists earn their income as small business owners. Most of them serve their communities by donating their time and products in support of causes, just as we see other businesses across the state doing. While the South Dakota Arts Council does award some grants to individual artists, these grants are project-based and make up less than 16% of the agency's overall grants budget. Take Tom, for example. Now, Tom is a stained glass artist in the northeastern part of our state. This year, Tom received an artist grant so that he could teach other people the joy of creating stained glass. Because of his classes, South Dakota has 87 more stained glass artists today. People who can tell stories through a unique and a powerful medium. And as he said, the Arts Council helps people find their own talents. And that's pretty special. Now, myth number three is that arts organizations are dependent on public dollars. And that's not true. Only 10% of nonprofit arts budgets are supported by grants, and only 2.1% come from public funding sources. These grant dollars are used to ensure access and to provide educational opportunities to all members of a community. Government funding is typically a small slice of the funding pie, but these small investments have a big impact. Every $1 of South Dakota Arts Council support leverages more than $14 in matching funds. The arts is a lean and an effective public policy asset. And as a story of their positive impact across South Dakota continues to unfold, I'd like to share my thoughts for a little bit here about how we can work together to propel our state and our communities forward. Now, economic growth is vital for all South Dakotans, and the arts play a very important key role in that. The arts can enhance state efforts to diversify economies, to generate revenue, to improve the quality of life, and to attract visitors and investments into our state. We're seeing great examples of these investments everywhere. Have you seen the new elevator mural in Falkton? Yeah. It's featured on the cover of the Arts Council's annual report that was just released today. I've seen it several times myself in person. It's impressive. It's beautiful, it's engaging, and it perfectly captures the community identity of that ag town. The mural project has sparked worldwide press, and it's inspired other South Dakota communities to think about what they can do to level and bring an important focus on their towns. So many of our state's major attractions are works of art. Without the vision and the hard work of dedicated South Dakota artists, we wouldn't have Mount Rushmore, we wouldn't have Crazy Horse, the Corn Palace, Dignity, thank you, Dale, or the Sioux Falls Sculpture Walk. The arts creates a quality of life, and it draws businesses and workers. People want to live in communities where they can experience the arts. Employers want their employees to have access to the arts and cultural activities. And high schools want to keep their students engaged. In South Dakota, nonprofit arts and cultural organizations generate an estimated $30 million in local and sales tax revenue each year. And they employ thousands of people. Many times you've probably heard me talk about improving South Dakota's relationships with our tribes. This is something that I'm incredibly passionate about. And I'm thankful to see the Arts Council is focusing there as well. This year, the Arts Council is prioritizing more grants and services to increase educational and developmental opportunities with tribal citizens and communities. Many projects are already going on in communities throughout South Dakota. The Oglala Lakota Art Space in Kyle. Yes, we should all be cheering for that. The Cheyenne River Youth Project in Eagle Butte. The Todd County School District's residency with Dallas Chief Eagle there, artist in residence, and multiple community art projects cultivated by the Sisseton Arts Council as well. They've been incredibly engaged. So I commend the work that is being done and challenge our arts community to continue to use your skills that you've been blessed with. Think about ways that we can work together to solve problems through creative initiatives in your own communities. I want to be your partner in this. Additional creative initiatives are happening outside of tribal communities as well, particularly with our state's veterans. I'm excited to hear about our aligned vision for the community of Hot Springs. Jim mentioned that earlier. We're using arts programming to improve the quality of life for veterans at the South Dakota State Veterans Home. This will involve students, local art organizations, and the public. It's a wonderful beginning to help with my vision of turning Hot Springs into a destination for veterans to celebrate their service to our nation. In 2017, an artist named Marcus Tracy was hired to create a mural at the State Veterans Home. The mural was of a tree, and each of the leaves was made from a handprint of one of the veterans or a veteran spouse who lived at the home. Veterans would tell their stories to Marcus as he worked to help them capture an outline of their hands on paper. Now, during that project, Marcus worked with a woman named Mildred, and she was the only surviving Native American woman Air Force service pilot from World War II. Mildred was bedridden at the time of the project, so Marcus sat beside her bed while he traced her hand and listened to her stories of her service during World War II. About 2 weeks after the completion of that veterans tree, Mildred passed away. And next month, she's going to be buried in Arlington National Cemetery. But just as her life made an imprint on American history, her handprint will forever be memorialized at the Hot Springs Veterans Hospital and Home, thanks to the incredible work of Marcus and the generosity of this South Dakota Arts Council. What a wonderful way to honor our veterans. And as we work together to continue to find creative solutions for problems that we face, please make sure that you share your stories with us, your ideas with us. Reach out to my office and to the South Dakota Arts Council. Talk with your legislators. And I want to thank all the legislators who are here tonight. Showing up makes a big difference. And I've always been a big believer in the proverb that says, what you see with your eyes, you carry in your heart. And by being here tonight and seeing these artists and interacting with them and people who are passionate about the arts, I believe you will be changed and you will carry arts in your heart from tonight. So there's no place quite like South Dakota. With the rich traditions and the creative talents of our people, South Dakota's cultural heritage and artistic vision is strong. So as we look to make South Dakota an even better place for the next generation, we must continually encourage our young people to try new things, to develop new passions, especially when it comes to art. I'm thankful for South Dakota's arts culture, and I look forward to the innovation that the next generation will bring to the table. Congratulations to each of you. Personally, you're an inspiration to me, and you'll be an inspiration to all of us for many, many years to come. Thank you. God bless you.